Hi, I'm Anshul. I'm an interdisciplinary studies major at the University of Texas at Dallas, and today I'm going to talk to you about cotton.
So, what are you wearing? Most likely, your apparel contains cotton. Being one of the most common natural fibers used to make clothing, cotton accounts for about 33% of all fibers in textiles. Today, cotton is found in many things, in clothes, bed linens, tablecloths, curtains, toys, yarn, seats for cars, and even explosives. However, our reliance on cotton can cause devastating environmental strain. Let's dive into the effects that come from the cotton life cycle through cultivation and textile production. Cotton is grown in more than 100 countries, with the major producers being China, USA, India, Pakistan, Brazil, and Uzbekistan. With global production of cotton increasing, many arid, hot regions of the world have to rely on irrigation systems to sustain the crop. One of the most common types of irrigation systems used in cotton cultivation is the flood or furrow irrigation, which takes water from a nearby water source and directs it to water the cotton field. This is a simple and cheap technique, but it wastes a lot of the water. It's estimated that 60% of all water used for flood or furrow irrigation doesn't even reach the plant. Furthermore, large-scale irrigation projects use dams to divert rivers, resulting in the reduction of downstream water flow. Take a look at the Aral Sea in Central Asia. The region around it is a major cotton producer, and the diversion of two rivers flowing into it for irrigation has caused it to almost disappear. Another set of problems comes as a result from helping the crops grow with fertilizers and pesticides. Fertilizers use a lot of phosphorus and nitrates, which run off into surface or groundwater, disrupting aqueous ecosystems. Overuse can harm nearby animals and people. Additionally, pesticides used to protect crops have increased local human exposure. One method of spreading pesticides is by spraying it from airplanes. This results in fast but inaccurate application and considerable risk in terms of pesticide drift. Cases of unintended contamination as a byproduct of cotton production have been reported in California, Uzbekistan, and Colombia. Once cotton is harvested and turned into textiles, cotton dyeing becomes a concern. It's one of the most contaminating parts of the whole textile process. It involves the use of vast amounts of energy, water, steam, and assorted chemicals such as bleaching agents, dyes, wetting agents, soap, softener, and salt. Even more, high amounts of wastewater generated in dyeing contaminates rivers and groundwater with toxic dyes from brominated flame retardants and stain repellents. These hazardous chemicals are extremely dangerous for plants, animals, and people that use contaminated water. I hope that you now appreciate that growing and processing the cotton in your t-shirt causes significant environmental problems, from cotton cultivation to textile production. Unless we better regulate conventional cotton production and transition towards organic cotton, the environmental impact will continue to build. While clothing is an everyday essential, we, as a society, must first become aware of the problems it creates before we can solve them.